On Christmas Day, children open their gifts, tossing away the ribbon, gift wrapping, paper boxes, etc. We too need to discard whatever comes in the way of receiving God's gift of salvation. We can discard our desire for self-satisfaction, self-righteousness, and self-promotion, so that we may discover God's continued presence and love. Our proclaiming, living, and being the good news is the best response we can make at Christmas.
Our entrance hymn, O Come, All Ye Faithful.
To God. O God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we, who have known the mysteries of His light on earth, may also delight in His gladness in heaven. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shone. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as they are glad when they divide the spoil. For the yoke of his burden and the staff on his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the trampling warrior in the battle tumult and every garment rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for the fire. For unto us is born, to us is given a son, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to God's word is, unto us is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in the present age, waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness and to purify for himself a people for his own possession, who are zealous for good works. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Great joy, for unto us is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
According to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment, when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in that region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Christmas is all about Santa Claus. It's about Christmas trees. It's about Christmas gifts. It's about new clothes. It's about shopping. It's about a commercial world. And that's how Christmas is celebrated by most of society and our world. Most of society and the world forgets that Christmas is all about the crib. If you take the crib out, there really is no Christmas. And each of us, my dear brothers and sisters, hopefully have at least prepared a little crib in our homes, a reminder to us of that first Christmas. Every church has a beautifully done Christmas crib in their church compounds or inside the church. And perhaps you and I have developed a habit over years to try and visit church to church to see the different cribs that are on display. But most importantly, to pay our respect to the Savior and Messiah who lies in that crib. Have you realized, my dear brothers and sisters, that in the crib we have certain characters, and these characters do not change at all, the traditional characters of the crib? Have you realized that each of these characters have something important and specific to communicate to us? Let us listen to the lesson that each of them give. And I wish to present 7 of these lessons. And I leave it to your choice to pick up whatever appeals to you more than the others and see how you can make it part of your life so that you too can be a part of the crib. The first lesson we learn is from the shepherds, a lesson in simplicity. The shepherds have an essential place in the crib. We cannot have a traditional crib without them. In fact, our own parish crib, we couldn't find the shepherds when we were searching for the statues. But somebody went all the way to Hill Road to pick up shepherds so that we could complete the crib. They were the first ones to be informed of the birth of the child, and they were the first ones to arrive on the scene. Not the great Herod, not the great high priests and chief priests, not the learned and the rich, but the simple shepherds, smelling of their sheep and tired due to the night watch. Our simplicity, my dear brothers and sisters, takes us closer to God, the God of the simplicity, the God who was born in most simple conditions. The second lesson we learn is from the beasts of the manger, the lesson of selfless giving. So in traditional cribs, at the back of our crib, most of us will put these 2 donkeys, and then there'll be some sheep, or maybe a cow, or something or the other. Without being very conscious about it, we give a very important place to the beasts, the cattle, the donkeys, and the cows in the stable. They were playing a very important role at the stable during that original Christmas. They were keeping the mother and the child warm at the delivery and even later. The warmth of the cattle was such an important element for the child. Just imagine, the beasts were not even aware of the good that they were doing. Look at the challenge that they throw to each one of us. To give and never to be conscious that we are giving. This selfless giving will take us to the crib, to God's presence easily. Lesson 3, from the angels, a lesson in service. All the traditional cribs have angels around. In fact, they were there all the time. The angels took messages to Mary, to Joseph before the nativity. They took messages to Joseph about the need to move and to protect. The angels were around to do what the Lord wanted. They were forever at the service of the Lord. When we are at the service of our neighbors, then we too become angels. In this time of COVID-19, we know so many of our frontline warriors who were angels sent by God to be at the service of others. Angels of the Lord, taking what the Lord wants us to deliver to others. The more service-minded we become, the more closer we get to the Lord, who came to serve and not to be served. Lesson 4 from the Magi, the wise men, seeking truth. The wise men who came to close the intense period of Christmas with their visit on the day of Epiphany are another very important part of the crib. They came seeking the Lord. They came seeking the truth. They came seeking for the one whom everything points to. They were seeking the Lord. And this is what has drastically disappeared in our world today. The world is no way excited about the coming of Christ. They're only excited about the holidays, perhaps discounts, perhaps which tailor we need to go to stitch our new outfits. But when we seek the Lord, we reach the crib. When we truly seek the Lord, everything around will bring us closer to God. Lesson 5 from dear Saint Joseph, the lesson of silence. Joseph listened and he carried out the orders. He spoke nothing. The silent protector of the Son of God and the Mother of God. And what a beautiful role he plays in the crib. Even there, quiet and peaceful, standing by with that manly gait, not seeking the limelight or trying to steal the show, controlling crowds or creating furor. He was not dictating terms to Mary, much less to God, placing his demands for the role that he has to play. But he was silent, a silent collaborator with the divine will. When we are silent, my dear brothers and sisters, we begin to sense the divine presence within and all around us. How important it is for each of us to seek this silence in a world that is so filled with noise. Lesson 6 from the loving Mother Mary, a lesson of surrender and obedience to God. Look at Mary now in the crib, my dear brothers and sisters. A mother's sense of fulfillment in her eyes and the loving gaze that spreads on her newborn son. That sense of fulfillment comes after a long process of surrender. The young maiden surrendering her life, perhaps all her dreams, all her aspirations. The spouse in promise surrendering her marriage and family. A loving mother surrendering all her expectations. When we surrender, my dear brothers and sisters, we see the Lord acting in and through us with mighty power and grace. May our own agenda fit with that of God's. That is what surrender and obedience to God's will is all about. And finally, lesson 7, from the little newborn, a lesson on self-emptying. This little newborn is so helpless. Can you imagine the word in and through which the universe was created? Yes, that word is made flesh and is now seen here as a simple, helpless infant at the mercy of the people and the beasts around him. The self-emptying of the Son of God begins here. Saint Paul would speak of it later in the letter to the Philippians. From the sky to the crib, and from the crib to the cross. It is a great self-emptying, and it was because of that God gave him a name above every other name. It is only self-emptying, my dear brothers and sisters, that will give us an identity as sons and daughters of God. Not our achievements, not our pride, not our riches, not our titles. We have to let go of everything so that we can let God in. We have to be detached from everything of the world so that we can be attached to God alone. This is what self-emptying is all about. So of these seven characters here, which one would you like to be? What lesson would you like to take to heart? Begin from today, my dear brothers and sisters, and grow in that virtue. The Lord will soon be born in your heart too, and then it will be Christmas all your life. I'd like to end this brief reflection with a small incident I always love to narrate about that Christmas play the nursery children practiced for weeks to put up for their parents. The day came and the play began. Mary with her stomach so big and Joseph with all the bundles on his shoulders knock at the first inn and the innkeeper, little child, shouts, "No place in the inn." They go to the second inn and the innkeeper shouts again, "Sorry, the inn is full." And the third house, the little chap peeps out and says, "No room in the inn, please." And when Mary and Joseph turn away with a sad face, that little chap from the third inn comes running out. And everyone is surprised because that was not what they practiced. But this little fellow, looking at the sad face of Mary, says, "True, there is no room in the inn, but there is little space in my room. You can come and stay with me." This is Christmas. To tell the Lord, the world says, there is no place for God here. But I tell you, Lord, there is space in my heart. Come. And the Lord shall come and will be born in our hearts.
Let us now stand and we will profess our faith using the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father for all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On this day, when the goodness and kindness of God our Saviour has appeared, let us, my dear brothers and sisters, humbly pour forth to him our prayers, trusting not in our good works, but in his mercy.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, bishops, clergy, religious, and the members of the Church that in integrity of faith we may await and welcome with joy whom the Immaculate Virgin conceived by a word and wondrously brought to birth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people in the world, that they may be open to spread peace and accept progress. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are oppressed by hunger, sickness, or loneliness, that through the mystery of the Nativity of Christ, they may find relief in mind and body. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here and those receiving the benefits of spiritual online mass, that we may welcome Christ and in turn learn how to welcome Him in the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions, we now pray in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, O Lord our God, that the Virgin Mary, who merited to bear God and man in her chaste womb, may commend the prayers of the faithful in your sight. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oh,
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer, firstly, for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and also with our bishop, and all those who hold to the truth and of the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred night, on which Blessed Mary the Immaculate Virgin brought forth the Savior of the world, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Prosagatus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, also for those to whom you are pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness for their sins, and ordering your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation. Be pleased to God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which shall be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Your servants and your holy people offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you've given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones you are pleased to accept, the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, to command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us for the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius Alexander, Marcellinus Peter, Felicity Perpetua, Agatha Lucy, Agnes Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and
thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pause a few moments of quiet prayer and reflection, preparing ourselves to receive Jesus in Holy Communion.
An act of spiritual communion.
O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Long time ago, in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible says, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may through an honorable way of life become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy night, drive far from you the darkness of vice and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue.
Amen.
May God will that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel. Fill your minds with the gladness he gives, and make you heralds of his gospel.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor, and make you sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And may the peace and blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll take the recessional hymn. Christmas, and we wish your family and friends as well.